Welcome to Analytics with Nux. In this video, we're going to see about row level security. And this is the part 2 of row level security video, as we already covered what is row level security and basics of it. And today we're going to deep dive into row level security with some new, what are the disadvantages of prior one, the one we have already seen about row level security, and how we can overcome with this particular DAX function, user principal name. Let us try to check it out in this video. Let's try to understand what happened in our previous row level security. The concept remains same. It is the core basics of row level security is to filter the underlying data and provide the restricted data access to the users. So what we implemented last time is like we have roles here, and you can see we have created two roles, one for Bangalore branch, and we have filtered the Bangalore location. And for Chennai, we have filtered the Chennai location. We have created two roles. And in the role management in Power BI services, we have added concerned users. This works fine for a small organization which is having 1, 2, 3, around 10 to 15 users and very limited locations, right? You can manage everything in the Power BI services, like add the users, concerned users over here. But what happens when you have more locations here, hundreds of locations and thousands of employees, and employees keep on changing different locations? So currently Lax is in Bangalore location. Now he moves to some other location, then you need to remove from here and add it here, right? Another location. So if the volume is too huge, this solution is not so effective. So how to achieve it? That's what we're going to see now. Now for that, let me explain the model, current model we have. Now we have a simple model here, which is having fact, dim product and dim territory, that is the location. Now this location contains data at the region level, northwest, northwest central, Canada, France. So this is the least level, and country is another level, the next level to it, and group is next level to the country. Now we got a country level security mapping. So we have some managers or users who should have access only to the country. So in those cases, how you will maintain is like, we will maintain the data like this. This particular user, the Nagendra, can able to see United States data. Even Yemen can see the United States data, and Lax can see the Canada data. So like this, you need to have one configuration table, which user can see which country. And note that a particular user can see many countries as well. I will show it quickly as soon as I show first demo. Like now we have three users, and we have two countries they can able to see, and one country can be seen by two users. This is fine. Now going back to our example, and what I want to do here is like, now we need to create a role, right? And before that, I want to explain the user principal name, what it displays, right? What it returns the results. So you see, I have created one measure, user principal name, and I will put it in on card and see what it returns. So this user principal name will give you the domain name / your username. So this is the user principal name. And you need to ensure, based on your organization, whether you need to go for user principal name or username. Usually username will give you the email address, and in my case I do not have I'm not connected to my organization account. This is my local account, so both will return the domain name / username. And based on your organization configuration, your username and user principal name will show you different results. So in this case, I use username, it shows same results. So what I'm trying to make point here is like, based on your organization configuration, what it will return, right? You need to store concerned data over here. If your DAX using user principal name, then store the value like this, domain name slash username. So that you need to ensure. That is the point I want to make here. Now, this is fine. Now, how the actual roles will be applied. Now, the role application is similar to how we have applied earlier. Now, I already created it for this demo. Let me recreate it. So I'm creating the country-wise role, country role. Now go to this table, that user access country, then create. Sorry. So create this table, click on this table and click on this three dot add filter username. Here you apply that function, user principal. I missed the N principal name, right? So this is the thing you need to apply it over here. That's it. So once you are done, you have applied the security over here. This is absolutely fine. Once you are done, you can go and check the roles over here, other role, country role, and use the value for Nagendra. I'm going to test it. Let's give this name. There you go. Once you apply it, you can see only the security roles are applied, right, for that particular user. Now we can add a few more data for Nagendra here. I'm adding France and Germany and try to see how it looks like for him. Now this user table. Now that is what I meant here. The management of user security will be very easy. You no need to touch anything in your Power BI. Everything can be handled in the database itself. Now again, when I choose other country, now I'm using the Nagendra here. Now the result set will give him three countries. Right now I need to refresh the data first, because it is not refreshed, it is old data. So once I refresh it, it will fetch the latest data in the data set or Power BI desktop. Then when you apply the security, it will give me three countries. So there is no need of adding this particular user in the role base, right? Earlier version is like you will end up creating three roles, and you will go and add that user manually every time it changes. But now this is eradicated, like you control everything in the database level and you apply security only once. So one, as soon as you refresh after changing the values in the database, then your security is automatically applied. So this is the best practice you need to follow up. So this is what I want to make. And once you publish this report, you always publish this report and you create a role. I mean, this role will be displayed there. You need to add the users. That is for sure. So let me apply it in Nag's workspace. Let us display it in the my workspace. There you go. Let's go here and see the RLS here and check the security part. There you go. You can add users, start typing the users. So this is not, as you can see, I'm adding the users at this organization, right? In the demo, I've used something else, but here the actual users belongs to this organization, that is Analytics with Nag's organization. Users can able to see it. This is, you might understand what it is all about. I hope you understand the concept behind the RLS, how effectively you can use. The farmer one, the earlier one we used is used, it is not a very worst practice. It is applicable for small organizations. When you dynamically keep on changing for big organization like this is the best practice you need to follow up on. And for that, you need to use user principal name and apply the security as we applied for other RLS configurations. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.